Okay, now before starting with practice set 2.1, we will summarize all the theorems we have learned before. We have learned interangle theorem, corresponding angle theorem, and alternate angle theorem. We'll be using all these three theorems to solve our sums. So, what are we given? Line N is parallel to line N. And two proof mein kya hota hai? Interangles are supplementary. Corresponding angles are of equal measure and alternate angles are of equal measure. So let's write what we can use. Interior angles are supplementary. C-shape angles are supplementary. These are your C-shape angle. Then we can take alternate angles congruent, that is Z-shape, and we can take corresponding angles congruent, that is F-shape. So this is a very simplified summary of all the three theorems which we can use. If you are given lines are parallel, to use any of these three property, what is the condition, students? Remember, lines should be parallel. Okay, so now we'll start with practice set 2.1. Okay, now are you ready to solve practice set 2.1? Yes, we have summary of all the three theorems. So exercise is very, very simple for us to solve. We are given RP is parallel to MS and DK is transversal, and we are given angle DHP is 85. You are required to find some angles. Angle RHD, RHD. Now before starting the sum, identify the angles in your diagram. It will be simpler for you to think which kind of pair are they forming. Okay, so we are required to find angle RHD. Then we have PHG. PHG. So this is one angle. Then we have HGS. HGS. And we have MGK. MGK. Now, obviously, when you are given line parallel, we will be taking any of the three we require. So first, let's start with RHB. Now, RHB, zara dimag lagane ki zarurat nahi hai, because it is adjacent to the angle you are given, angle DHP. Let's draw the diagram separately. This is your DHP and this is your RHD. So, ye kaun sa pair form ho raha hai? Linear pair angles. Very simple concept. So, koi shadow apply karna nahi hai. Directly, we start with the linear pair angle. And before taking linear pair angle, we have no statement ke line parallel hai, transversal hai. Just simple start with linear pair angles. So, angle DHP, angle RHD equals to 180. Linear pair angle. We substitute the value. DHP given hai. 85. You are given. So you get your answer 95. Okay. So ye first ho gaya tumhara. Now let's look for the other angle, PHG. Again, a very simple concept. We have learned in earlier chapter, vertically opposite angles are congruent. So this is your RHD and this is your PHG. Again, a very simple sum. No use of your information of parallel lines. Now, RHD is congruent to PHG, vertically opposite angle. So angle PHG also equals to 95 from 4. So here we have one more value. So far, very simple sum. Now HGS, HGS. Now this requires application of the theorems we have done. Let's identify कौन सा shape form हो रहा है. C shape form हो रहा है. Yes, C shape form हो रहा है. Z, no, HGS का Z कोई नहीं है. F, yes, F form हो रहा है. This and this students. A very simple concept to understand. ये 85 BHP and ये HGS. These are both angles in F shape. And F shape angles are congruent. Alternatively, we could take interior angles also. Interior angle supplementary, but that would increase your calculation by 4 steps. So simple, corresponding or directly equal होते हैं, तो तुम्हारा calculation simple हो जाता है. So and yes, before using any of these three information, ये हमें लिखना है statement that lines are parallel. So our statement will be lines are parallel. Line RP is parallel to line MS. You are given. So angle DHB is congruent to angle HGS. Which angles are they forming corresponding angles? So we will write reason as corresponding angle theorem. DHB का measure क्या है? 85. So HGS is also 85. Reason क्या लिखोगे? Given, because you have substituted the value from the given information. So here we have one more value, HGS. Now next one, MGK. Again a very simple concept to identify students. X shape angle form हो रहा है. So HGS is congruent to MGK. HGS, MGK. So angle HGS is congruent to angle MGK. Vertically opposite angle. Therefore angle MGK also equals to 85. From 9. Okay, so now you clearly understood the application of theorems. कि कैसे सब में apply करना है when you are given lines are parallel. Okay students, let's start with question 2. We are given line P is parallel to line Q and line L and line M are the transversals. We are given some measure 110 and 115. I have named the angle as E and F for reference purpose ahead. We are required to find angle A, B, C and angle D. Okay. So again we start with identifying the type of angles which are formed. Let's check out for angle A. Angle A is over here. And angle E is exactly adjacent to it. So what's the angle form? A very simple one. Straight line. So angle A and angle E are in linear. So let's find the value of angle A. A का measure given नहीं है, हम find कर रहे हैं. E का है 110. Reason given. So angle A equals to 110. Very simple, first one. Now let's move on to next one. Angle B. B कोई shape form नहीं हो रहा है. C C मिल सकता है. Students, P and Q is parallel and M transversal है. तो C और F का कौन सा shape form हो रहा है? I'll draw the diagram separately. ये है your line P and line Q. This is your transversal M. This is your C and this is your F angles. So what type of angle is formed? F shape angle. Simple. transversal and your two parallel lines. F shape angle क्या होता है? Congruent. So angle F and angle C will be equal, corresponding angles. Before using it, क्या लिखने वाले हो? Parallel lines. So line P is parallel to line Q and students यहाँ पे दो transversal है. So कौन सा transversal लिखने वाले हो? जिस transversal पे angle form हो रहे. Very simple to understand. You see in the diagram, we took P and Q lines. अभी बचा यही line है. तो ये line कौन सा line? M. No need to get confused among the two transversals. Given. So angle C is congruent to angle F. Reason, corresponding angle theorem. F का measure क्या है? 115. So C का measure भी है 115. Reason given. So we got one more angle. Now C मिल गया. D. D कौन सा shape form हो रहा है? Adjacent angle पता है उसका हमें F. So again a very simple. D and F. Straight line है. Linear parallels. So angle D plus angle F equals to 180 linear pair angles. F is 115 given. So angle D equals to 65. We got a third measure as well. Now we have only one remaining angle, angle V. Now what most of the students make mistake over here is angle V and angle D को corresponding angle ले लेते हैं. Why? Because ये F दिख रहा है लोगों को यहाँ पे. But L and M are not parallel. We are given P and Q are parallel. तो उस lines पे transversal जो angle बनाएंगे वो पहले हम लेंगे. L and M clearly are not parallel. So B and D cannot be a pair of corresponding angles. Okay? So P and Q parallel है तो वहां से हम कुछ यहाँ पे shape identify करते हैं. हमें E पता है, you know A also. Now ऊपर एक F form हो रहा है यहाँ पे. P and Q are the parallel lines. P and Q. L is transversal. L is transversal. Okay? So B किसको equal होगा? यहाँ पे जो angle होगा वो. Let's name this angle something. Let's name this angle as angle G. तो G and B will be equal. And G again किसको equal है? A को. Because उसका vertical opposite है. So मिल गया simple. Angle A and angle G equal, vertically opposite, and then angle G and angle B are equal because they are corresponding angles. So next step, we are going to take angle A equals to angle G. Vertically opposite angle. So A का measure क्या है? A का measure है 70. We got in fourth step. So G is also 70 from 4. G हमने 70 क्यों लाया था? वी फाइंड आउट करने के लिए. और वो करस्पॉन्डिंग एंगल शेप फॉर्म हो रहा है बिफोर दैट अगेन पैरेलल लाइंस एंड द ट्रांसवर्सल. सो लाइन पी इज पैरेलल टू लाइन क्यू एंड हुज अ ट्रांसवर्सल एल डी एंड जी वहां पे फॉर्म हो रहे हैं. सो एल इज ट्रांसवर्सल. So angle G is equal to angle D. Corresponding angle theorem. G का measure है 70, so B का measure भी है 70 from 30. Hence we have received all our four required angles. Question 3 of practice set 2.1. We are given line L is parallel to line M. And also line N is parallel to line P. So unlike last sum where there was only one pair of parallel lines, बाकी दोनों पैरेलल नहीं थे. यहाँ पे ये दोनों पैरेलल है और ये दोनों भी पैरेलल है. सो व्हेन एल एंड एम आर पैरेलल वी कैन हैव एन एस पी एस ट्रांसवर्सल्स एंड व्हेन वी टेक एन एंड पी एस पैरेलल एल एंड एम विल बी द ट्रांसवर्सल्स. सो इधर हम ट्रांसवर्सल मेंशन नहीं कर रहे. लाइन एल इज ऑल्सो पैरेलल टू लाइन बी. वी आर गिवन वन ऑफ द मेजर विच इज 45. नेमिंग नहीं है सो वी विल नेम इट एज ई. So we will write angle E equals to 45. Find क्या करना है? Angle A, angle B and angle C. So to find angle A, angle B, angle C. So let's identify concept type of angle बन रहे हैं. A, B और C सबसे पहले क्या मिल सकता है?
A.
A तो कैसे मिलेगा? Which type of angle is being formed? F shape बन रहा है बट ये मिलेगा. If you take F shape angle, so it will be this, this and this. तो तुम्हें ये वाला angle मिलेगा, okay? और ये वाला मिलेगा तो A मिल जाएगा linear पे. A मिलेगा तो B मिल जाएगा vertically opposite. And B मिलने के बाद
C.
कौन सा shape बन रहा है?
F.
उल्टा F बन रहा है, okay? Everything is connected. So तुम्हें ये angle find out करना है, but इधर mention नहीं किया है नाम. तो डायग्राम में मेंशन इसको कर दो डी. ओके सो हाउ आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द सम. तुम्हें ये वाला एफ शेप लेना है. सो व्हिच आर द पैरेलल लाइंस?
एल
एंड एम. एंड ट्रांसवर्सल क्या है?
पी.
पी इज अ ट्रांसवर्सल. इजी टू आइडेंटिफाई. ये दो पैरेलल लाइंस है और ये वाला जो लाइन है दैट इज द ट्रांसवर्सल. सो वी विल स्टार्ट आवर सम विद लाइन एल इज पैरेलल टू लाइन एम. And who is transversal?
P.
P is transversal. Reason क्या आएगा? Given. Margin में you can draw this shape. कौन सा shape ले रहे हो? So it is easy for you to identify which are the parallel lines and which is the transversal. You won't get confused. So ये छोटे वाले shapes margin में draw करो. So which angles are congruent? Angle E is congruent to angle D. Reason? Corresponding angle theorem. Therefore, angle D is equal to 45. Reason given and from 2. Now, 1 mil gaya. ये कैसे मिलेगा?
लीनियर
पे. सो ड्रॉ दिस शेप. यू आर टेकिंग लीनियर पे. एंगल ए प्लस एंगल डी इक्वल्स टू 180. लीनियर पे एंगल ए का मेजर वी नॉट नो. डी इज 45. रीजन फ्रॉम
3.
We continue our solving. Plus 45 becomes minus 45 in RHS. So we get the answer 135. Now don't do box in the answers. So we get A as 135. We got one of our angle. Now to find B, what will take?
Vertically
opposite angle. This shape. A is congruent to B. So angle A is congruent to angle B. Vertically opposite angle. So therefore angle B is also 135. From
7.
Yet if you want to write, maybe likho ge to chale. A aur ek mil gaya.
C corresponding angle.
Now B and C are corresponding angles. कौन सा शेप फॉर्म हो रहा है? ऐसा वाला है फॉर्म हो रहा है यहाँ पे. दिस इज बी एंड दिस इज सी. सो व्हाट आर द पैरेलल लाइंस?
पैरेलल
एम एन पी आर द पैरेलल लाइंस. एंड व्हाट इज दिस ट्रांसवर्सल? ट्रांसवर्सल इज एम. सो लाइन एन इज पैरेलल टू लाइन पी एंड लाइन एम इज ट्रांसवर्सल given. Therefore, what is the next step? Angle B congruent to angle C. Again, same reason. Corresponding angle here. Therefore, angle C equals to 135. What is the reason?
From 9.
B ka measure kaha pe hai? 135 on 9 step. From 9 and 11 और ओनली फ्रॉम 9 भी चल रही है. ओके क्वेश्चन 4. इट्स अ बिट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम व्हाट यू हैव डन इन अर्लियर सम्स. वी आर जस्ट फाइंडिंग द मेजर ऑफ एंगल्स. नाउ हियर वी आर गिवन साइड्स ऑफ PQR एंड एंगल XYZ आर पैरेलल टू ईच अदर. ओके व्हाट आर द टू साइड्स ऑफ एंगल PQR?
PQ
and QR. And what are the two sides of XYZ?
XY
and YZ. So the sides are parallel to each other. Obviously we can make out XY will be parallel to PQ and YZ will be parallel to QR. What are we required to prove here is angle PQR congruent to angle XYZ. This angle is congruent to this angle, we have to prove. Now here we are going to do construction. Extend XY. Now in geometry, whenever you extend lines, it's always linear extension. Linear extension means, suppose ye line hai diagram mein. If you are going to extend it, we will do linear extension. We cannot do it slant. Okay? So you just extend it in a straight line. Teda meda extend nahi kar sakte kabhi. Okay? So whenever we are talking about extension, it always means linear extension. Means the points are collinear. Okay? So we will write name this point as S. We write given sides PQ किसको parallel है? XY को. So PQ is parallel to XY and YZ is parallel to QR. What are we required to prove? We will write that from the question. Angle PQR congruent to angle XYZ. Construction, what have we done? We have extended XY which intersects QR at point S. So how do we mention it? Extend seg XY such that QSR. QSR means these three points are collinear. वो शॉर्ट में हम कॉम्पैक्ट में ऐसे लिख सकते हैं QSR. ओके Now how are we going to prove the angles congruent? ये बातें लिखना. We are given PQ and XY are parallel. Which shape is being formed? which shape of angle is formed? This and this is parallel. F shape angles are formed, corresponding angles. So, angle Q is congruent to angle S. Right? Which shape is formed? F shape angle. And when I consider the other pair, YZ and SR, कौन सा शेप फॉर्म हो रहा है? और एक F फॉर्म हो रहा है, ऐसा वाला. तो Y और S भी congruent है, Q और S congruent है, S और Y congruent है. तो S और Q और Y भी congruent. Okay? This is called the concept of transitivity. 1 is equal to 2, 2 is equal to 3. तो 1 और 3 भी equal हो गए, it's simple. So suppose this 1 is equal to 2 and this 2 is equal to this 3. So ye dono bhi simple hai, equally honge. That's it. So how do we start? We start with the F shape angles. Aisa wala form ho raha hai. Okay. Which lines will you write?
QS.
Lines कौन सा लिखोगे और transversal कौन सा लिखोगे? Tell me that. Transversal तो easier में दिख रहा है, पीछे का Q R. Parallel lines कौन सी?
P Y S S or Y S or Y P or P or
parallel. Parallel lines. P Q and X Y. P Q and X Y. वही है ना? एक ये parallel है और दूसरा ये parallel. Q R transversal आ गया तो parallel line कौन सा बचा? यही बचा है. So, PQ is parallel to XY we are given. But हम लोग कहाँ तक ले रहे हैं? इधर तक ले रहे हैं? तो वापस हम next step repeat करेंगे. PQ is parallel to XS. Y की जगह हमने S लिखा. Extend किया इसलिए. And who is the transversal?
QR
is the transversal. Reason from construction. Okay? Y की जगह हमने S लिखा, बड़ा line लिखा, तो वो कहाँ से लिखा? Construction. Angle, which angles are congruent? Give me the three letter name.
PQR.
PQR.
XSR.
XSR. Okay. Now students, PQR. X S R F shape हो रहा है, तुम Y S R भी लिख सकते हो. X S R Y S R is one and the same. Same ही line में है, तुम angle इधर तक लिखो या इधर तक लिखो. This part is important for the angle, not this part. So reason corresponding angle yes. Sorry here. One pair is done. Now other pair. वो कौन सा F है?
S.
What are the parallel lines and what is the transversal?
Y is the transversal.
Y is the transversal. X is. Transversal सबसे पहले mention करते लो. X S is the transversal. What is the parallel line?
Y Z.
Y Z. SR. Y Z is parallel to SR. And X S is transversal. Given. Okay, what are the pair of angles? Harsh.
What?
Which pair of angle are congruent?
Why?
I have given you the shape. Tell me which angles are congruent.
X, Y, Z.
Angle X, Y, Z is congruent to? X, Y, Z is congruent to? I have marked it.
X, Y, Z.
Y, S, R or X, S, R. When I am the same. We have written X over here. So, we will write X over here as well. If you have Y written here, then you have Y written. So, compare करने में easy पड़ेगा तुम. Again same reason, corresponding angle theorem. Now our sum is done. LHS is same. Sorry, RHS is same. So LHS is also equal. XSR, XSR same. So A or AB. It's the same concept used to take in vertically opposite. When RHS is equal, LHS is also equal. But उसमें LHS में दो terms होते तो they cancel हो जाते. इधर तो LHS में एक ही term है. So ये sum is over. From reason क्या आएगा? 3 and 5. Hence, proof. The question 5, practice 2.1. We are given AB is parallel to CD, PQ is transversal. We are given one measure 105. This 105 means angle BRT. Okay? This is not mentioned in given in your sum, but we will write in the information. Okay? Sorry, BRT. And we are required to find out angle ART. Let's mark the angle so that you will understand which type of angle is being formed. We are required to find angle ART, CTQ, DTQ and PRB. PRB. Four angles we are required to find. Okay, let's concentrate on the first one. Which pair is being formed? Now, how many pairs of angle do you know? We know linear pair, vertically opposite, interior, corresponding, alternate. Out of those five, which is being formed?
Linear
pair is being formed. Simple. ऐसा form हो रहा है. ART, BRT. Linear pair, straight line. So start with that.
Corresponding.
बाद में आएगा. ये corresponding है. So why? First we'll start with linear pair. Angle ART plus angle BRT equals to 180. Draw that diagram in the margin. ART we do not know. BRT is 105, 180. What are the reasons? First one, linear pair. And second one, we have substituted the value. कहाँ से?
Here.
Was given. So go ahead.
Seventy-five.
We got our first five. This is done. Now which pair of angles?
Vertically opposite.
This angle is vertically opposite. ART and PRB. X-shape angles. So angle ART is congruent to angle PRB. Vertically opposite angles. Therefore angle PRB is what? 75. Reason?
From
4 and 5. Then this and this, which pair is being formed?
Corresponding
form हो रहा है. ये 105 है, यहाँ पे 105 F
shape
और ये भी F है, दोनों F. We know this also, and we know this also. तो ये 105 तो, ये भी 105 और ये 75 है, so ये भी 75. And before taking corresponding, what will we write? Come on, what do we write?
Corresponding.
B R T. कौन सा? है. Yes.
Parallel.
भूल क्यों जाते हो? Parallel line and transversal. So what are the parallel line? parallel. It has only one pair, no confusion. एक ही line parallel है, transversal भी एक ही है. There's no confusion regarding it. You write the whole thing. Line AB is parallel to line CD and line PQ is transversal. Reason given. So suppose we take this F, angle BRT, DTQ, BRT and DTQ. It's congruent to angle DTQ. Corresponding angle theorem. So angle DTQ is
105.
Reason
from
8 तो है ही है 105 कहाँ से है
105
given 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 given
given
given
from 8 and given
और 7
तो parallel line next pair ये वाला F it's again same information so we won't repeat same parallel line same transversal है so we don't have to repeat just write the pairs of angles So angle ART is congruent to angle CTQ. Same reason, corresponding angle theorem.
Therefore
angle CTQ is 75. Reason?
From 10M given.
75 given नहीं था, 75 कहाँ से आया?
4.
इधर से 4. So from 4 and 10. You don't have to mug up the reasons if you understand तुम कौन सा step 2 लिख रहे हो